Welcome back to Flash of Arrows. This is the Superman fanboy, Leonard, and this is my boy, the Marvel asshole, D.
What's up?
And today, I'm going to talk about, or should I say, more like rant, on people who've been bitching, moaning, groaning about Arrow Season 3.
They have reason to.
Really?
Yes, they do.
Of course, they're going to mention that basically because of, with Season 3, because of the villain who's on, mainly on there, is Ra's al Ghul, who is, of course, as everyone knows, a Batman villain. And that they're borrowing him for Arrow Season 3. My personal opinion, I don't have a problem with it. Why? Because there's another web, there's a web-based TV show that currently uses a Spider-Man villain as the main villain of a certain superhero. And I think you know he's kind of, he wears red, lives in a hellish part of New York City. He's a man who's fearless.
A man without fear.
He's fearless. But anyway, just say he's fearless. But
Daredevil, by the way.
Yeah, Daredevil. I didn't want to
get Hell's Kitchen.
That. Whatever.
And is it the Kingpin you're referring to?
The Kingpin, who began as a Spider-Man. Wow.
You forgot to turn that shit off, did you?
Yes, I did. I forgot to turn that off.
It's his girlfriend. Don't worry about it.
Yep. Don't worry about that. Yes, I gave my girlfriend the CM Punk theme. I gave her that. But anyways.
That tells you the truth about his masculinity anyway.
Of course. Absolutely.
Anyhow, continue it.
Exactly. First of all, people should not complain about other shows using super villains from other shows. Because think about this. Your boy Spider-Man, right?
Yep.
One of your favorite superheroes.
Yep.
Did you know he fought Doc Ock? I mean, not only Doc Ock, but fought Dr. Doom.
Yep.
Who is related to the Fantastic Four?
Mm-hmm.
He fought Magneto. Who did Magneto's more connected to?
The X-Men.
Mm-hmm. He also fought Galactus.
Yes, he did.
The Planet Devourer. Who's more associated with?
Silver Surfer?
I think so. You could say that. Like I said, they borrow other villains from other comics all the time in the comics.
Well, the problem with the people who see these series and shows is a lot of them aren't fan-based. They're actually new fans, and they're only fans of the TV series. I will defend you on that issue. They don't realize that a lot of the storylines for these villains trace back to multiple heroes, not just one. The League of Shadows is this issue.
Mm-hmm.
League of Shadows is ran by Ra's al Ghul. Green Arrow, and I think four other characters in the DC world have direct ties to it, including Batman. So the fact that this is even becoming an issue for you people is because you don't know your source material. You shouldn't be complaining about it. Now, if they go in and put, you know, Brainiac in freaking Green Arrow for no apparent fucking reason.
Then you have every right to complain. I'll be there with you complaining till the cows come home. But you have to understand that Green Arrow has connections to the League of Shadows, not just I'm Batman. No, because plain and simple, Arrow has a connection to a guy named Deathstroke.
Yep.
Who is the only person that knows his secret identity other than now half the people.
Now.
In Starling City. But anyways, that's a whole other rant, but I can get that in a whole other day. The second part of my rant is the fact that everyone has a problem with Olicity, which is Oliver and Felicity's little on-again, off-again relationship. Personally, like I said, are you freaking surprised, people? It's a CW.
Has to be romantic somehow.
It has to be romantic somehow because majority of their shows on their channel, outside of Arrow, Flash, and Supernatural, involves the female demographic.
And thus, you should expect it.
Exactly. Did you people not watch Smallville? How many girlfriends did Clark have?
Do we really need to go through that?
Exactly. I mean, he went through so many, he went from Lana so many times, not even funny. Lana was with him. Then Lana went to Lex. Then went back to Clark. Then she left. Then he went to Lois.
Then there was Chloe.
And then there was Chloe.
Then it was Lois.
Then it was Lois.
Then there was the back again, forth with her, with Chloe and Clark talking about how they still cared for a while.
Then Chloe went Jimmy. With Jimmy.
Mm-hmm.
Married with Jimmy until Jimmy was killed, which was bullcrap.
Yeah, totally.
And then after that, then Chloe found Green Arrow.
And I ain't gonna lie. The fact that people are so upset about the villain thing, I'd be more upset about the fact they had a fabricated fake Black Canary. It wasn't even the right person. Come on! I'm not even a DC fan. Come on!
Of course. We all knew that. Okay, everybody like, and the worst thing about it is the fake Canary, which was Sarah.
Yep.
Everybody likes her over Laurel.
Which is ridiculous because Laurel is the original.
Exactly. She's learning on the fly how to be the Canary. Because this is like her first time on the job, people. You think somebody is going to be really, really good at the first time on the job? Trust me, I know this. I watch Man of Steel.
Yeah, I was about ready to say, anybody who's watched our past videos, he's got a real kick for this first time on the job shit.
Yes. First time on the job, you're not going to be really good. Trust me, Batman sucked at his first time on the job.
I don't know, Daredevil did pretty good until Ben Affleck played him.
Oh, don't you get me started on that horrible movie.
Don't worry, Batman will get there soon.
He will redeem himself in Batman Superman Dawn of Justice.
You're praying, I'm hoping. That's all I gotta say.
Hey, Chris Evans got a second chance. Look what look how he did. Aha!
Chris Evans didn't ruin something completely, though.
Oh, Fantastic Four he didn't ruin?
Actually, not really. Not compared to some of the other actors they used. The only actor I truly enjoyed in terms of the way they acted was the guy who played Ben Grimm. I can never remember his name.
Michael Chiklis,
that's it. The guy they got for Reed Richards. He looked the part, but I just didn't feel it. And Sue, it was all about sex.
I hated Dr. Doom in that movie.
Yeah, Dr. Doom sucked ass.
I hated him. Maybe he could go back to Latveria and stay there.
You see, and you're all happy about the new remake they're fucking making. Anyway, that's whole different rant. Let's not get into that. We'll do the Fantastic Four rant at a different time.
When we see the movie,
because I'm going to give it a break. I'm going to try, even though they're changing everything. Because today's day and age, there has to be some kind of change.
That's right. A brother's going to be the Human Torch. That's right.
I can make such a racist comment about burnt skin, but I'm not going to. Wait, oops, I did. Anyhow, I just wanted to hit that with you really quick. So, do you have any more you want to rant out?
No, well, there is one more thing about Arrow that I wanted to get part on, is that the fact that the one thing I want to really hate on the show about is the fact that they turned the Atom into Iron Man. I mean, if you look at his suit, he looks like a freaking watered-down Iron Man with a bad budget.
I told you that was going to happen.
Yes, you did.
As soon as you said he was going to be part of the show, I was like, Iron Man time. You're like, no, they'll never do
that. I mean, when I first saw him fly in, the first thing I said was,
nice impression, by the way.
Yeah, no problem.
Anyway, I think we're going to cap it off with that, because, I don't know, he's kind of grinding on the rant.
Yes.
He's just going to keep going. So we're going to cut him short, give everybody your piece. He'll probably do it to me later anyway. Once again, catch us later on Flash of Arrows. And a kick out to Sean, who's our main man in production of the video, etc. and so forth. Hit him up. He's a great guy. And once again, fanboy.
I am the Superman fanboy, Lenore.
And I'm the Marvel asshole, D. We'll catch you later.